Hi, it's Bob Kraft of TennisMinistry.org. We're doing a series on pro tennis players during the decade 2000 to 2012. And this one is about really the former top doubles team in the world, which was Cara Black and Liezel Huber. It's hard to really talk about them individually because they were together for a long time. They were number one in the world in doubles at two different periods of time, and then they quit playing together. And I was involved with them during that entire process. I was around. So I'm just going to talk a little bit about that. Liezel Huber, who lives in Texas with her husband, originally from South Africa, she became a Christian at some point in her life in the last 10 years. I forgot the exact year. She became a born-again Christian, and she had the WTA put in their newsletter her testimony, which I have, and I'm going to post on my website. And it was fabulous. I mean, it's something that even the WTA, to do that was very unusual, you know, to write about a player's Christian life. And she told me, Liezel told me, I asked her about it, and I said, this is when she was playing with Cara, and I said, you know, all of a sudden she stopped talking about her faith, Liezel did, to other players publicly. It was all, before it was public, she'd do it a lot in the press interviews and so forth. And she said, well, she received a lot of opposition in the locker room. And I think that shut her down. You know, other players came up, she told me, and whatever they said to her. And so I think it made her sad or afraid or whatever. And she just didn't talk about her faith publicly after that. Now, during the, and she still doesn't to this day, it's rare to hear her mentioned. When she and Cara were playing, so she was a Christian, Liezel was, and she was encouraging her husband to grow closer to the faith. And Tony's a very calm, rational guy, nice person. And I sat with them, you know, and they were playing number one in the world. Cara was not a Christian, and her husband, Brett Stevens, was not a boyfriend at that time, and then shortly during that period of time got married. They were not Christians. They really didn't talk about it. They weren't too interested in talking about it. They knew Liezel was a Christian, and they allowed her to talk about it, and I'd sit in at the table. And Cara, there was a split there between Cara and Liezel, and they just had to do really with the husbands a little bit, between Tony and Brett Stevens, a different approach. You know, Tony's very professional, he's a professional coach, and Brett's a little bit more informal. He was a trainer, he's not really a coach, so he feels that Cara can learn without a coach, really, a professional style coach. And so there was a split there, and you know, when I saw that coming, I was involved in that. I was around when that was all happening. It took a long time, hours and hours and hours of prayer for that, because it was a bitter split. They didn't talk to each other. Brad and Tony wouldn't talk to each other, whereas before they were close to each other and they were always doing things together, sitting at the same table. And, you know, I just felt, well, Liezel's a Christian, and certainly, you know, she can have influence on Cara, and, you know, it shouldn't be like this, where a Christian is not talking to someone she was so close to before, or her husband. And it just took hours and hours of prayer on my part that there would be reconciliation there, because, I mean, it was so bitter that they just wouldn't look at each other, wouldn't talk to each other, and actually were angry at each other. And so the miracle happened about a year, and they were number one in the world when they split. So that's an amazing thing, because it involves a lot of money, and along with all the titles that you give up. And as soon as you take on a different partner, there is very little chance that you're going to be number one again, because the chemistry and the shot selection is so different. So that's pretty much what happened. And then the amazing thing is happened is that Brett Stevens, from Australia, they got married, he and Cara. He became a born-again Christian. And I don't know how that happened exactly, but he turned his life over to Christ and he loved Christ. And that was something I never saw coming because he never talked about that at all when I was around. And then he became a Christian and he had influence on Cara, his wife, some influence. So he brought in this coach from France who started to be around. Now that coach teaches people to actually dislike or hate other kinds of Christians, which is a different, which is actually ultimately led to their second breakup, I believe. But he has a bitterness in his heart toward certain kinds of Christians. It's not just about, well, I don't agree with what they stand, what they're believing, but I actually hate them. You know, it's a big difference, right? And so they came back together again based on their Christian faith. And Cara was very new believer. I could say she's not really a believer. I don't think she's committed her heart. But she was studying, reading the Bible. And Brett, for sure, I've spoken to him. He is a Christian. And then Liezel, again, she's not speaking publicly, but privately, you know, she'll tell her doubles partner. So Tony and they all came together and they became number one again in the world. And it really had to do with their Christian faith. And they were together for this period of time, for probably a year and a half or two. They got to be number one in the world. They were dominating. It was very interesting because whereas before I could sit at the table and be part of the group, all of a sudden I was excluded. I was not really thought of, well thought of by them. Liezel and Tony were still friendly. Brett was kind of friendly, but he was always looking for a way to make it, you know, for me to say the wrong thing. I always felt like that. And Cara just wouldn't say a word. And what I felt during that period of time is this coach from France was coming and sowing seeds of hatred within that circle of people, and particularly toward Brett and Cara, because he spent a lot of time with them, but the four of them. And I could do nothing except stay outside, and obviously I have lots of players I was working with, so it wasn't a major thing to me. And, you know, stay away and pray for them and say hello if an opportunity arose, and that was basically it. And so because of this seed of hatred that was being sown there, and I could see it, because you could just feel it in their eyes when you walk by. It's not what a Christian should think like or act like or look like. And, it was inevitable that that was going to break apart, and that's exactly what happened. Cara and Brett have hatred in their heart from this particular coach who preaches this under the guise of Christianity. And they had hatred in their heart toward, you know, a seed of hatred isn't necessarily toward one person. It has to do with the seeds that there, and it manifests itself in many ways. And so it wasn't really about me. And Liezel and Tony, when I saw them after the break the second time, they were fine with me. I sat down with them. I said, you know, and they went over the circumstance. They said Tony had Brett Stevens was trying to hire this unprofessional coach, which I totally agree with. He's not a high-level professional coach for the number one doubles team in the world. And he felt that they should have a different approach, so there was a break. But there was also, I think, really the real issue there was it was a spiritual break of hatred versus love. Because Liezel, who's been born again, has a spirit of love in her heart and kindness, even though she doesn't say much now. And Tony's, you know, quiet kind of a guy. And so that's the circumstance, and they've been apart now. And Cara's dropped off the map with her ranking. She's very low. I don't think she's found a consistent partner now to play with. And Liezel's actually at the top of the world. She's number one or two or three ranked now in doubles. I believe it has a lot to do with their spiritual outlook, what was put into their hearts. So Cara's heart and what was put into Liezel's heart, it was much different. So that's the situation there with a former number one doubles player. Now, if they had stayed together, if they had been together working in a spirit of love, if Cara and Brett had been working in a spirit of love, I think that they would have stayed together. Love would have covered a multitude of sins, a multitude of problems. The Bible has stated that between them and between others. And I think they would have won many, many more titles, and they would have made much more money, which would contribute to their retirement. And I think it would have been a different situation. But again, we can just pray for them. That's all. Pray for them as individuals, as couples. God bless.